and singer Marcus Collins will battle it out for the X Factor crown tonight after Kelly Rowland's remaining act, Amelia Lilly, was voted off. But who will take the top spot and will the win guarantee them long-term success? We'll hear from former contestants. Same difference in just a moment. Very good morning to you. First though, let's have a look at the final acts performing with their mentors last night. She takes care of herself. She can wait if she wants. She's ahead of her time.
Second act still in the final of the X Factor. Marcus.
So there we go. Sean and Sarah Smith, otherwise known as the Same Difference, are here. 2007.
Yes.
Your year.
Jeez, it seems years ago now.
Isn't that
amazing? Years ago.
So talk us through what we saw last night and the ones left in. Marcus, for example. Now, he had the opportunity to sing, of course, that duet, which is, I mean, what an opportunity.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, with Gary Barlow, he's always going to deliver. You know that he's so well known and loved by so many fans, and that's such an opportunity for him. I think he's been a great mentor to Marcus throughout the whole show.
Yes, and I'm intrigued, Sarah, that we've got no solo female singer now in the final. I mean, through the last three, but now gone.
Yeah.
But Amelia, she was out at one point, wasn't she? And then came back in, so there's a bit of a story attached to that, but.
I think with Amelia, because there was so much in the press all last week about it being fixed because HMV had a problem and they put up that the winner single was Amelia and then had to quickly take it down again. Because of that, I think that really hindered her last night because people go, well, it's a fix anyway, so we don't need to bother voting if we like her.
Well, that's it. I mean, all that stuff, of course, is all completely denied by the programme organisers. But, I mean, a lot of those stories have been rumbling around this year, and there's been a lot of other stories about the goings on behind the scenes as well, that's been more, it seems, than ever before.
Yeah. I mean, we wouldn't know what to say about that. I mean, we always take it as from face value, you know, but I mean, we certainly felt, particularly in the final, we kind of had a feeling that things weren't going our way, or it was
the way press
yeah.
I mean, looking at back over last night's show, I think when they were stood there, she knew she was going, and she was like, I'm just going to keep a smiley face on, and I know that when I come out of this, I've just got to work twice as hard if I'm not the winner.
A Little Mix, let's talk about them, because this is an all-girl act, and, you know, they seem to be very, very popular. What do you think is the thing they've got that is so appealing to people?
They're really lovable as a girl. I think they've all got great voices, and kind of like the girls next door. I mean, rather than wearing heels or put flat shoes on, they're much more sort of friendly and bubbly and sweet.
Yeah, I think, and also with the girl that had the thing about her weight issue, and because she's come out and she's openly said, you know, we're not all perfect, no girls out there feel that they're perfect, and I think because she's actually openly spoke about that, I think the younger audience especially have really gone, you know what, I feel just like her, and I'm really going to latch onto her, and I think it's the younger fans, especially at the moment, that are voting for them because they really think, oh, they're just like me. And when you're watching something, if you can see yourself in some way, it makes you like them more, I think. So
people are always very fascinated in what happens after X Factor. Give us, I mean, for you guys, you know, you didn't win, but you've managed to forge yourselves in a career.
Yeah,
I mean, we still had Sing For Supper. We went on the X Factor tour and had to prove ourselves to Simon Cowell. And after 3 months, we found out that we had a deal, but for some it will happen straight away, others might take a little while longer, depending on how much of a calling there is. I mean, you can usually get a sense of who probably will get a deal and who won't.
And the fan base follows you, because you're in performances right now.
Yeah, we're in Panto in Boxbourne at the moment, and it's been amazing. Like, even just yesterday we had fans come down all the way from Birmingham to see us and things, and it's been really, really lovely because we've had a following that's stuck with us and they've grown with us, because people that were kids back then are now kind of teenagers and they could turn up to shows and they're going, oh, it's like really nice to see how we're progressing as well as performers.
Name, give me one name for a winner.
Oh, I'm going to go Little Mix.
I'll go Marcus.
Okay, there you go.
Yes, split opinion.
We'll see.
Come see us in Phantom.
Thank you very much for coming this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.